There, Jade here, still here at the cottage, and I'm stealing a few minutes away from my family and friends and kids because I just got a birthday present, and surprise, surprise. So that is one, my first deck. That's my birthday present from my other half. And the second one is Mystic Mondays. I'm wearing sunglasses, so it's very hard to see if I can actually, what you can actually see. Now, Fountain Tarot is a deck that I originally had on my wish list, and I took off, actually, because, I don't know, I saw some walkthroughs online. I wasn't super crazy about the backs, and when I looked at the walkthroughs, the art didn't pop out to me. The edges are gilded and silver. Now, this has surprised the hell out of me because when I look at the artwork in person, it's such a totally different experience than it was from looking at it on YouTube. So I'm just going to do a quick flip through. Actually, sorry, I'm trying not to make a mess here. And I think I'll just put the cards back in the box as I go through them. Okay. Judgment. I think I'm going to have to do this another time. The cards are quite thick, quite sturdy. I like that a lot. I love this moon. Something I've just noticed is that the number on the majors are all different colors. Love that death is a horse. Anyway, I won't go through them all because I'm sure that everyone has seen these before. But I just wanted to say that this was such a surprise to me. How much I would love this deck. The artwork is fabulous. I'm really looking forward to working with this fool. Get to some of the coins, and I'm sure that you can't see any of this. So, that's a two. I love that two of coins. The only thing I will say is that the guidebook unfortunately doesn't talk about what these paintings are. So I understand that each of these is an original oil painting, and I don't know anything about them. I would love to look into them and see if I could find out more about the artists and how they came about some of these images. It's the card from the creator, writer, designer, publisher. that's the Fountain Tarot. Comes in this fabulous box. And I might actually keep it in this box rather than putting it into a bag. The other one is the Mystic Mondays Tarot, a deck for the modern mystic. And this one, I have to say, this is a story by Grace Duong. This is another one I'm going to say has totally surprised me. I did watch some YouTube unboxings. It's freaking me out that I can't hear anybody. And again, it's another one that I had on my list and then saw some unboxings of it and decided to take it up. Here is the backs. And again, I know that this one is quite old, so I probably don't need to go through all of them, but let's see if I could do this without making a mess. The Fool. I'm not going to go through all of these because, again, I think can't see them very well in this glare. I love this strength card. Them very thought-provoking. So I'm looking forward to working with this one as well. But it really did surprise me. I did not think that this would be one that I would be really into. The one thing I will say about this one that I was a bit disappointed with, the edges are also gilded, which is awesome. The one thing that is disappointing is that the guidebook, it does come with a guidebook, and I don't have it here. But the guidebook doesn't include anything at all about the deck, the creator, or how the deck came to be, or anything like that. It simply starts on page one with the majors, and then goes to the end. There is one or two pages for each card. But I would have liked to have seen a little bit more of a description of what the deck is all about. Anyway, that's it for me. I'm going to shut this down and go rejoin my company and have another beverage. Right now I'm enjoying this, see if I can get it in, Social Light Vodka Soda Field Strawberry. It's very nice. I like it because it is not sweet. Anyway, until the next time, my friends, tell your truth.